Come in.
Governor?
I take it the meeting's over.
Yes, it is. And it's my duty to inform you that until Mrs. Morris is reinstated as deputy governor of this prison, all officers are on strike.
She shouldn't have to cope with things like that.
I couldn't agree more. That's why I've decided to take her away for a couple of days. Just till this ruckus blows over.
That's a great idea.
Then if this madman does decide to come out of hiding, nobody can think it's me, can they?
You know, there might even be a way of making sure of that.
Get in here where no one can see you.
I thought you said you lived by yourself.
I do, but my sister's down for a couple of days with her son, Mike. You can stay here until they're gone. They'll be gone in a couple of hours.
Help! Somebody! Lexi's sick! We need Sister Hall! Somebody help! Somebody help us!
Kelly should have been transferred to Blackmore. You made a mistake, Moran, that has caused me a lot of problems. As from this moment, Mrs. Morris is reinstated as deputy governor and you are relegated to the rank of senior officer.
As I told you, I felt yuck when I woke up this morning.
So?
And I'm a week late. Bloody Jesse and his stupid ideas about having it off with a garbo.
Morning sickness.
It was no use kidding myself.
Not the duff.
I'd rather go skinny dipping in a tin of grease than clean up that lot.
Yeah, I heard you had to mop up Patterson's cell.
Yeah, just change the subject, thanks.
He looks like he's just been to his own funeral.
Yeah, he just about has.
I heard a couple of screws gas bagging on me way out.
What'd they say?
Strike was because of him. The minister came and ripped his stripes off in person.
You're kidding.
Oh, did they say who's replacing him?
They're putting Morris back in.
They reckon the freak stirred up the whole thing.
So what's new?
Hey, you playing?
Yeah, in a tick. Come on.
You're supposed to be exercising, Connors.
Yeah, I already have been, right? Listen, I wouldn't normally say this to a screw, but I'm real sorry about what happened. Being shoved down a peg. It's a pity you had to take it out on me.
Well, don't lose too much sleep about it. Nothing's changed as far as you're concerned.
It still doesn't make it any less rough on you.
All right, just go and join the others, eh?
You better still, why don't you join us? Just like getting the aggro out, eh? Hey, what do you reckon, girls? Nothing like a bloke on the team, eh?
Moran, have a go, you mug!
Jeez, look what I've done! Oh, no, I'm for it.
You okay?
No, I'm all right, all right.
Oh, Mr. Moran, I didn't mean to hit you. You've got to believe me, honest.
All right, Jenkins.
Whatever's happened?
Ah, just an accident. Yeah, you stay here and take over while I go and clean up. Then get back to what you were doing. Go on.
First the rights, now this. I'll be sent to Blackmore for sure.
Oh, he's not going to hold it against you. Maybe we've started something.
It's just hit me.
What?
A fair dinkum game. Us against them, we could beat the pants off them. The Wentworth Warriors versus the Staff Screwballs, eh? Oh, no,
you gonna be all day?
Nausea better?
Yeah. Look, if you're too busy, I'll come back later.
You'll stay right where you are. Now, look, you think you might be pregnant, right?
Yeah, I told you I'm a week late.
Come on, Lexi, it's not another put-up job, is it?
Look, I've never been late in my life. Can you just do the test? You know I don't want no ankle biter.
Very well, then.
How long is it going to take?
Just a few minutes. Mind you, it could be too early to tell. Whatever you got up to when you escaped mightn't show up yet.
Yeah, well, if you must know, it was before I escaped.
In here?
Yeah. Had it off with this bloke in the garbage truck. If you don't believe me, you can ask Moran. He caught us at it.
Oh, come on, then.
I'll leave you together.
Oh, thank you. Sit down, Jesse.
You got my letter, then?
Yes.
Well, things are looking up, eh? There's no way he won't be out there searching for Kelly.
You're convinced it's Bassinger, aren't you?
Well, of course I am. Why?
Well, Bassinger's on holidays with his wife in Brisbane. And a little while ago, the prison got the second of two phone calls from someone claiming to be Flynn's murderer. Local calls.
So it's a hoaxer.
Well, the police are not so sure. And if Bassinger's the maniac you painted him to be, why isn't he down here doing what you said, looking for Kelly?
Well,
Are you sure it's him up there? Could be somebody covering for him.
Well, the police got a trace on the last call to a phone box. By the time they got there, the caller had gone. The shopkeeper remembered giving change to a man at the time the call was made. A young man, slight. No way it could have been Bessinger.
Well, doesn't prove anything one way or the other.
Well, no, not of itself. But it doesn't actually help us either. Look, Jesse, are you 100% certain that Lexi isn't lying?
Absolutely.
Hmm. Well, the police have got a considerable case, you know that.
I'd stake my life on it. She's not lying.
Well, I'm not sure I would. Unless I can be convinced otherwise, I'm not sure that I can continue with the case.
Well, am I or aren't I?
The test's positive. Look, I'm sorry, Lexi, but I'm going to have to tell the governor.
I wonder what Sister Hall's got to say about Patterson. She looked awful.
Little drama merchant. I'd diagnose a clear case of malingering.
Oh, come on. I hardly think that's fair. Bob! Bob, whatever's happened to you?
Ah, one of the women clocked me with a volleyball. It was just an accident.
Yeah, sounds like it.
It was.
Oh, come on, Moran. Recent events have proved your judgment to be rather fallible.
I'll save the commentary, Ferguson.
You needn't pull rank. We're all on the same level now.
I could be in the gutter and not be on the same level as you.
You are in the gutter, Moran. It's about time you realised it.
Just one more word, Ferguson.
You saw that? He was going to hit me.
I wouldn't have blamed him if he had hit you. You've done nothing but campaign against him ever since he got here.
Only for the good of the place.
Oh, more for the good of your own personal spite. Look, I'm sorry I have to say this. I'd much rather you didn't come to our wedding.
Well, thank you very much. You see, that saves me the trouble of cancelling. Because, frankly, I've got far better things to do with my time than watch you getting hitched to some shonky little cook.
How dare you! Oh! Oh!
I could so easily have hit her. That's why I'm here. I want to apply for a transfer.
A transfer? Surely it can't have been as serious as that.
Just the tip of the iceberg, and I don't think it's a good idea to stay on now I've been demoted.
You know you have my full support, and Meg's. No one regrets what happened more than she does.
I know, but my mind's made up.
At least consider it for a few days. Will you come in?
Sorry, I didn't realise you were busy.
It's all right, Miss Ferguson. I was just leaving. Governor?
What is it, Miss Ferguson?
I wish to register a formal complaint about Mrs. Barry.
I see. And what's she done this time?
Lashed out without provocation and struck me on the face. I want it dealt with.
Any witnesses?
Yes, Di Hagen saw the whole thing.
And nothing you did helped bring this outburst on?
Oh, she started babbling some nonsense about withdrawing my invitation to her wedding, became hysterical and struck me.
There must have been some reason. It's completely out of character.
It's not up to me to account for her actions.
Don't you find it coincidental that most of the recent staff problems involve you in some way?
I'm just doing my job. But I will not be attacked by anyone. Now, are you going to do something about it, or will I?
Well, it was good while it lasted. Yeah,
yeah, yeah. We'll have to give you a couple of lessons in catching up.
Oh, I think I was very good for a beginner.
Yeah, well, I bet I get it in the neck from Mr. Moran.
Let's put a sock in it.
Oh, look who's back.
Shut up.
Oh, sorry, I spoke.
What'd you say?
Yeah, what's the verdict?
You've been blabbing.
I never said anything, honest.
Blabbing what?
Keeping secrets, are we?
What is it, Lexi? I'm up the bloody duff.
Pregnant?
Yeah, bun the oven, potted hole in one. You name it, I'm it.
You've got to be joking.
Oh, that's great.
Isn't it?
Yes, yes, of course it is.
No, it's bloody not. So why don't you all stop being so nice?
It was that garbage bloke, wasn't it? Chalked it up in one.
Shove it, Rita. Come on, Chuck, I want to talk to you.
Ahead of all of us. Now she's in two clubs.
What am I going to do now?
Well, you got to look after yourself. You got to eat lots and build yourself up and no smoking because they reckon the nicotine affects the baby.
You reckon I want the thing?
I know it's a bit of a shock. You just need some time to think about it, that's all.
I don't need no time at all. Who'd want to bring a kid up in a place like this? That's not the point.
Oh, bull it isn't.
If they hang this passenger thing on me, I'm going to be stuck in here for years.
You don't know they will.
Oh, of course they bloody will. He's a tin god to every cop on the force.
Hey, Lex, you thought up a name for the little tyke yet?
Yeah, bloody Ben Hur. What do you think?
Oh, right. I was only trying to be nice.
Look, just calm down, Lex. You're not thinking straight. This gives you something to get out for. It's great.
It's not going to happen.
I've just got to get rid of it real fast. An abortion? They'd never let you have one, not without a medical reason. And I'll just have to fix things up myself, won't I?
Lexi, don't be stupid. You could die if you do something like that.
Look, you don't have to keep it. When it's born, if you still feel the same way, you can have it adopted.
What about the kid? Born in a crap heap like this, and then dumped. Huh, no way.
Oh, Joyce! Joyce, have you heard the news?
No. Oh, Patterson's pregnant.
Oh, really? Good heavens.
Yeah. What's wrong?
Nothing. Nothing. Oh, everything. Haven't you heard?
No.
I slapped Joan Ferguson's face.
You did? When?
Yes, at morning tea. She kept needling Bob and I stuck up for him and then I told her I didn't want her at our wedding.
Good for you.
Oh, then she got really vicious about Mervyn and me. What pleasure or satisfaction she gets out of it, I'll never know.
Sounds like you've just done something that we've all wanted to do for quite some time.
Oh, I didn't realise what I was doing. I just lashed out. She's reported me.
Oh, yeah, that'd be right.
Oh, but I feel such a fool. At last she's made me lose my dignity. Oh, she'll make a major issue out of this, Meg. You mark my words. I might even lose my job.
Oh, no, you won't. Now, don't you worry about it. It's just not worth it. God, how dare she insult you like that?
Oh, I was still in the wrong, Meg.
No, she's the one who's in the wrong, and I've had enough of it. This is the one time she's not going to get away with it.
Oh, Meg, could I see you?
No, later, Andrea. I've just been talking to Joyce.
Really? And I suppose you were bent over with pity for the poor little thing being driven to attack me.
God, drop the sarcasm. I've just about had you up to here.
Oh, really? I thought you might be quite well disposed today, seeing I got you reinstated.
Oh, for whose benefit?
Well, you seem quite happy to reap the benefit.
I've also had you lashing out at everyone.
Me? Lash out?
Yes, you. God. You've turned provocation into a fine art, haven't you? Now, of course she was upset. Who wouldn't be? You can forget that incident with Joyce and lay off her.
It's too late. I've already written the report.
Then tear it up.
Oh, like hell I will.
You will if you know what's good for you. Otherwise, I might just go to the police and tell them about the fire at the Bikies' house.
You fool if you did.
I know you lit it. We'd both know it. It was revenge, wasn't it?
Who'd believe you? The police are interested in fact, not fantasy.
Oh, the police mightn't. But the conquerors might.
Rubbish.
Think what the conquerors did to the Eagles when they thought they'd done it. Ooh, very nasty.
You haven't got the nerve,
don't
Morris.
Count on it. Someone's got to stop you. Now just tear up that report.
They tell me you're feeling better.
Yeah, I'm okay.
Lexi, love, I've got to talk to you.
Yes, you do. Want to talk me out of it, right?
Well, that lawyer's been here to see me.
Eh? Well, what do you have to say?
Well, it's not looking good for us, love. The prison have had two phone calls threatening to get Lou.
But that's great. That's just what we wanted. Yeah. That bastard's on the move again.
Yeah, except that he's been cited and they don't reckon it's passenger.
What? Oh, then they've got the wrong bloke.
You sure? Lexi, love, have you been straight with me?
What are you talking about?
Well, all that business about Bassinger, you know, before you bashed him, telling you that he'd killed Nora.
I don't believe I'm hearing this. You reckon I made it all up?
Oh, I wonder. I just don't know. The lawyer has doubts.
Oh, bloody great, and he's supposed to be defending me.
Yeah, well, Bassinger's clean. There's not a single thing pointing to him.
He's a nutter, a fruitcake. Of course he's going to cover his tracks. Oh, look, Jess, you saw the state I was in.
Yeah, I know, but
Well, you're a smart kid. You could put on a pretty convincing act if you thought it would save your hide. And I wouldn't blame you. And if you haven't been telling the truth, for God's sake, do it now before it's too late.
Do you think I'm lying? It's a bloody point.
Of course there's a point.
Am I interrupting?
No, you're not interrupting nothing. I've just about had enough for one day.
Did you manage to talk her into not going through with it?
With what?
With the abortion, didn't she say?
You mean she's pregnant?
Yeah, I thought she would have told you.
Oh, I didn't give her a chance. God, that's why she was so sick.
Yeah, Sister Hall did a pregnancy test.
Oh, I've been writing her about this other bloody business. Oh, I could cut my lousy tongue out. But what's this about an abortion? She's not having any bloody abortion.
Yeah, well, that's what I tried to tell her.
Yeah, well, you leave it to me, silly little bitch. I'll get her straightened right out.
Oh, hey, Mr. Moran.
What are you going to chuck at me now?
Oh, that's what I wanted to talk to you about. I didn't really mean it, see?
Forget it.
Yeah? Well, I just didn't want you to think that I meant to hurt you. You know, is that okay?
Good as new.
Oh, good. Well, they told me you've been having a bit of a rough time lately. I didn't want to be adding to it.
Why all the sudden concern for the screws?
Oh, I ain't got no gripe against you. None of us have. Just wanted to tell you.
That's good to know. Packed quite a wallop with that ball. They'll be after you for the Harlem Globetrotters if you're not careful.
Maybe they could get me a release, eh?
You just keep practicing. But not on me.
Sister and her boy have gone home.
Oh, coast clear then, are you?
Yeah, all clear.
Hey, look, there's no chance of a feed there, is there? I mean, I'm starving.
I suppose you would be with all that running from the law. Come on up, yeah. And I'll make something for you.
Oh, Mrs. Jenkins. I'm real grateful, you know. It's just that I didn't have nowhere else to go.
I won't be pretending I'm liking it. But since you're Alice's friend, I suppose I haven't got no choice. Like bacon and eggs?
Yeah, sure.
Come on up then. I'm glad Alice didn't try to escape with you. If you ask me, you need your head red.
Well, I had to get out. Some of them bitches had it in for me.
Well, how'd you upset them then?
Well, that's just it. I didn't. See, I'm not much of a fighter. So once they started picking on me, I mean, there wasn't much I could do.
It seems to me you can look after yourself pretty well.
Oh, no, not me. I hate violence. Well, that's why they picked on me. Because I'm a pacifist.
How'd you get the wrists then?
One of them decided she wanted me dead. I shared a dorm with her. Didn't get to sleep much, you know. Next thing I know, she set me up. Tries to electrocute me in the kitchen. Oh, well, that didn't work. Slipped me wrist. Tried to make it look like suicide. I mean, I had to do something to protect myself.
Look, I'll put you out for a couple of days, like I said, but then you'll have to move on.
Just like it my strength up, eh?
And I don't like bludgers. I'm short a hand and you'll have to work.
Work? Oh, I don't reckon I could do that. I mean, I've lost a lot of blood
you
here.
You managed to get here so you can earn your keep. After you've eaten, you can go and muck up the donkey stall.
All right, 200.
Oh, I couldn't.
Geez, Lurch, 220 then. Look, you won't get into trouble. I'll make it look like I started it, and all you've got to do is give me a few hard ones in the gut.
No way. I don't want any part of it. It's disgusting.
You reckon I'll be asking if there was any other way? They're going to be watching me, aren't they? I've got to make sure it looks like an accident.
You reckon they wouldn't guess? Look, you know the rules around here about anyone pregnant. They'd string me up as a kid killer. Forget it.
Where's Betsy? She's just round there.
No, you don't. I've been looking for you everywhere.
What for?
Well, firstly, to apologise. Hassing you about Bassinger. Obviously, I picked the wrong time. I didn't know you were pregnant.
Yeah, well, the whole bloody prison knows now.
You're going to need all the backup you can get. I'll stick by you and bugger that lawyer. I'm going to take you in hand and make sure you look after yourself properly.
I'm not having the kid, or didn't Jules tell you?
You're having it, and no arguments.
Just because it was your idea gives you no right telling me what to do. It was a bloody stupid idea in the first place.
It was the only thing that would get you away from Kelly. And you're going through with it.
Oh.
Oh, love. I don't want you making a decision you'll regret. I know what abortion means, even in the right conditions, how it can tear you down.
Yeah, you must have had a few been on the game all them years you got by.
Got by, yeah. I'm going to make certain that you don't have to get by like I did.
You're the last bloody person I should be listening to. Just butt out. It's got nothing to do with you.
Rack off there, you. Move.
G'day. Amazing who you find cleaning out donkey pens these days. Alice told you she had a brother, didn't she?
Yeah, sure she did.
What did she tell you about me?
Oh, you know, this and that.
Yeah, just drop in on Mum. Give her a surprise. Reckon you're the surprise.
Well, what she said?
Relax, okay? She told me the whole story. How you on the run.
Well, you're not going to put me in, are you?
Come on, you're my little sister's mate.
You here by yourself?
Yeah, I'm a bit of a loner. Been knocking around up the bush. Matter of fact, I ain't seen no Sheilas for quite a while. Not like you, anyway. So how long you been in the slammer?
Long enough.
What for? Robbery? Murder? Yeah, I reckon it's got to be one of those.
Never you mind.
Whatever it was, must be a long time between drinks. Reckon a broad like you'd be hot to trot after all them years locked away.
Yeah, well, you reckon wrong.
Come on. I thought you'd be nice to me. Assume you want to stay here, that is. I could always play your cover. Think about it.
Oh, hello.
Hi. What are you doing?
I'm writing up my diary.
A diary? What for?
Well, I've made a pact with myself. Make an entry every day.
Oh, wouldn't be much to write about.
Oh, I don't just write about things. It's a way of keeping tabs on my thoughts, how I'm thinking about things. I write about the good things when they happen, and I try to understand the bad things. You know, find a reason for them.
I can't even write a bloody letter. Mum's always complaining I never write enough.
Well, this is very precious. It's going to be my present to my son, Peter.
How's that?
Well, he worries terribly my life's going to be wasted in here. And I want to show him it's really been quite constructive.
You, put anything in there about me?
Yes. Well, most of the others, too. It's hard not to. It's a small community.
Is it all bad? About me, I mean? Suppose it is.
No, not at all. Everyone has their positive side.
Yeah. What about the riots? Me ganging up with Lou against the rest of us.
Oh, that's water under the bridge. Lots happened since then.
Yeah. Reckon I'll never do nothing like that again. It's funny, you know. Feel different about a lot of things lately. I feel real bad about hitting Mr. Moran. I just told Lexi where she could get off to.
Oh?
She wanted me to belt into her so she could lose the kid.
Oh, that's dreadful.
Well, don't you tell anybody. I don't reckon she'd get anyone to do it anyway.
Well, let's hope Jessie can talk her out of it. From what Julie said, she's determined to.
Yeah. Wouldn't want her to mess up her life, eh?
How about a quick cuppa?
Oh, thanks.
You know, I think the best thing you ever did was falling out with Lou. Now you're starting to think for yourself.
Yeah. Wouldn't mind making up for some of the things I'd done in the past, either. Like how we locked up Steve and Merv, poor buggers.
It's a wonderful thought. There must be some way.
Yeah, well, Steve would be easy. Well, I was going to get some more copies of that centrefold smuggled in.
Oh, no, I think that would be the last thing he and Julie would want right now.
Yeah, I know. Lucky old Chucky, eh? Well, reckon I'll just chuck them out. Wouldn't mind keeping one on the quiet, though. Still think he's a spunk.
Well, I'm sure he'd be very grateful to you and, oh, flattered, too, if he ever found out.
Yeah. Don't know what to do about Merv, though. Yeah. Maybe I've got an idea for him, too.
Oh, what?
Yeah. Why not?
I've come to collect your bed and board.
Oh, bugger off.
I've heard how you girls keep yourselves entertained in there. Reckon I'll just jog your memory about the real thing.
No bloody way!
What? What's the bloody waste?
Filthy bastard!
Oh, you fight, do you? Come with a bit of spirit.
No!
I reckon that one's a must. Now, what else? Of course, we could always suggest a freak gets a permanent transfer to Darwin, but I don't reckon even Reno could get that one.
I bet she'd like to. Oh, is that the list for Mrs. Reynolds?
Last chance cafe, sweetheart.
Well, Alice has got an idea, haven't you?
Yeah. Blimey, there's a first.
Oh, I'll give us a break.
No, really kidding. Come on, let's have it, Einstein. The list you in first thing this morning.
Well, I reckon we ought to cook a special breakfast by ourselves on the day before Merv and Mrs. B get hitched. Well, it'll give Merv a break from the kitchen and it'll be like a special wedding breakfast. To wish him good luck.
Well, what do you say, girl?
I reckon it's a great idea.
Well, stick it down, Chookie. Hey, I could make the hash cookies. Get the marriage off to a real good start. Oh, g'day, Mrs. Barry. We were just talking about
you. Come on, please, ladies. Make room for us, thank you. Now, this is another donation of broken toys for the kids in maternity. Some of them, of course, are quite unsuitable for the age group.
You got anything for my age group? A Harley Davidson, maybe?
All right. That's enough. Now, in the past, the women have donated some of their wreck time trying to repair them. I mean, it's entirely up to yourselves and it's all purely voluntary, but I'd be very grateful if you'd help out.
Oh, I reckon it'd be a great idea.
Yeah, I'd like to help.
Yeah, me too.
Well, it sounds unanimous, so leave them with us. Right. Don't suppose there'd be any toy detonators in there, would there? I'd stick a place called Dynamite, maybe?
They've all been thoroughly checked.
It was the joke, Joyce. Yeah, it was a bad one, I know, but you could at least smile.
Well, never mind, ladies. Look, I believe there's some sort of a list here for Mrs. Reynolds.
Yep, signed and sealed.
Right. Well, I'll see that she gets it right away.
Excuse me, please.
She's full of beans, isn't she?
Yeah, I wonder what's wrong.
Now, what have we got here? Any ideas what this is used for? Don't answer that.
So you had a run-in with her, too?
In quite a morning. What was said?
I just delivered a few home truths. I think it might actually have an effect this time.
Already has. She came to see me to officially withdraw the complaint.
Good.
What did you tell her that we both haven't told her a dozen times before?
Well, I think it was the way I put it. I was very angry.
Don't blame you. She's been worse than ever lately.
Yeah, especially since those bikies wrecked her house. I think that was the last straw.
It's not as though we didn't try to help her over it, especially you, Mick.
Yes, I know. And then there's been the Bob Moran business.
Perhaps I could persuade her to take some leave before she becomes totally impossible. Might help her settle down a bit.
Well, I don't like your chances, but make sure that she keeps her hands off Joyce and Virgil.
Yes.
Come in.
Here's that list of suggestions from the women, Mrs. Reynolds.
Thank you. Let's see. Quite a document. Joyce, I hope you're not too upset about what happened with Joan this morning. I'm sure it wasn't your fault. There certainly won't be any action taken.
Very kind of you. That be all?
Yes.
Oh, no.
What?
That I can do without.
You're a little spitfire, aren't you? Knew you'd be a goer.
You lay one finger on me, and I'll kill you.
You won't try nothing. See, I'm the mum's favourite boy. She takes my advice. If I tell her you're not being too friendly after all the hospitality she's given you, she'll send you packing in 5 seconds.
You pig!
Don't play Lady Virtue with me. I've had a few letters from Mel too, you know. She tells me things she wouldn't tell her mum. I know what you've been up to in there.
Bullied.
Yeah. I know all about you. You and me have got a lot in common. We know what we want, and we go for it. Oh, don't get me wrong. I'm not complaining. Nothing wrong with a bit of rough stuff. It turns me on. Catch you later.
Sheila's.
All right, haven't got me eye in.
in yet, have I?
Well, try using both of them and makes a hell of a difference. Oh. Come on, Nancy, it's your game. Remember, we're ahead.
You should have been a sports mistress.
Depends what sport you're talking about.
It's got 14, yeah. And Lurch's side's got 3.
Come on, Vix, you're going out.
Why don't you just quit following me around?
I haven't finished talking.
I've already told you I've made up my mind. Now back off!
You in it, Lex?
What's all this crap then?
What does it look like? The Wentworth Warriors Bowling Championship. Give you and the Rugrat a bit of exercise, eh?
Thanks a bunch.
What'd they say? What about you, Jess? Bar one for Lurch. She needs it.
You seen Steve? Last time I saw him, he was headed out into the ground.
Oh, bugger, it'll have to wait.
A strike.
I'd love to talk to you.
Well,
come on. Okay, girls, hold on to your hats. Here comes Rita the Beater.
Sorry to whisk you away like
that. Oh, I'm glad you did. Volleyball and skittles in one morning. I am worn out.
Well, I've just got to talk to somebody or I'll burst. It's that stupid little bitch. She's dead set on getting rid of the kid.
So I gather.
I've tried to talk to her, but she won't give me the time of day, stubborn little cow.
Yeah, Julie's been trying too. Well, I suppose she just may need a bit of time and then change her mind.
She's so bloody hot-headed, just like... Well, she's liable to do something crazy any minute. I've just got to stop her.
Well, look, I don't agree with abortion, Jessie, but I suppose she feels that it's her body after all. It's her life.
Oh, if only it were that simple.
I didn't know you had such strong feelings about it.
Oh, I've never felt so strongly about anything my whole life. Oh, hell's bells. I've got to stop her. What a bloody mess.
Jessie, tell me, what is it?
Can you keep a secret?
Yes.
In deepest confidence?
Well, we're sharing one already about Peter.
I'm her mum.
What?
Lexi. She's my daughter, my own flesh and blood.
Noise, I could hear you in the staff room.
Oh, well, it must have been the girls cheering about going back to work this afternoon.
Yes. Always the comedian, eh? Well, let's see how funny you are with the governor. She wants to see you.
What for?
Ah, something to do with that ridiculous list of yours. As usual, you haven't known when to draw the line. Now, get going.
Oh, dear. I wonder what's the matter with it.
Sounded pretty reasonable to me.
Yeah, it's probably my idea about the breakfast.
I don't know why Mrs. Reynolds would object to that.
Hey, look at them two. I think I'll find out what's going on.
Well, it looks pretty private to me. Come watch telly instead.
And you mean that's the only reason you're in here?
That's right. Wasn't too hard getting Nick, not with my connections.
That's the most amazing story I've ever heard. Well, I had to see how she turned out. I couldn't help myself.
Why did you leave your curiosity so late?
Oh, Nance, I wasn't exactly a textbook mum. Far from it. There were reasons. But you know what they say, your conscience always gets to you in the end. Well, there she is, 5'2" of living, breathing conscience.
Well, now I know why you've been watching over her like a tigress. Oh, I can just imagine how you felt when you first saw her.
First time I saw her, she ran over my corns with the skin. Cheeky little bugger. Chip off the old block, you know? Hard as nails on the outside and like marshmallow underneath. We've had our run-ins, mind, but now... Oh, I hate to think what she might do to herself.
Why on earth haven't you told her?
Well, I kept on thinking that there would be a right time, you know?
And then she left, you see, and the Bassinger thing happened. Well, I wouldn't be much of a witness if they knew I was a mother.
Yes, I see.
Not that that had helped much now. They'll never believe her. That bugger's covered himself.
What's stopping you now?
Oh, God. I don't know. You tell me.
Maybe you're afraid. You're afraid she'll judge you and reject you.
Yeah. Maybe you're right at that.
Do it, Jessie. Take the risk. It could be the one thing that would stop her having the abortion.
Some of these items have a lot to recommend them. Like the wedding breakfast, I think that's very thoughtful and we'll do our best to organise it.
You can thank Lurch for that one. It was her idea.
Well.
Her heart's in the right place, even if nothing else is.
I also think the volleyball competition has possibilities. As for the officers not wearing truncheons, that's already being seen to. What I do not appreciate is this reference to Dan Moulton.
Well, I reckon he'd make a terrific chaplain.
Now, Connors, you can't possibly expect me to believe it's a serious suggestion.
Of course it's a serious... Oh, you mean...
I mean I don't appreciate personal deep.
Now, hang on. He was a mate of mine years before you knew him. If you're on together, good luck
That's
to you.
That's enough.
But... Now, look. He's the best Bible basher there is. If he can get his message across to a bunch of bikers, then I reckon he'd be dead set for this place. He'd be better than that snotty-nosed old codger you got at the moment.
I know Father Harris isn't perfect.
And another thing, it wasn't my idea. It was Nancy McCormack's. There's no way she'd want to embarrass you. I'm just asking for you to give the man a go. What you and him get up to out of hours is your business. If anyone can swing a miracle, I reckon he can.
Thank you, Connors. That'll be all.
Connors?
Fix it so that we're alone, will you, Ned?
Oh, yeah, leave it to me.
Glad to see you got an appetite.
Thank you for two, aren't I? Look, if you're going to come the motherhood bit again, I'm going to ram this down your bloody throat.
All right, keep your hair on. I just want to tell you a story about a friend of mine and Mabel's.
Oh, forget it, will you?
Look, you don't have to say anything. You just have to give me an ear. I reckon you owe me that after all we've been through together. Now, look, this friend of mine goes back to the days of the club, see?
Club, eh? Real nice way of putting it.
Well, she was on the game, like me. Made a pretty good go of it. Only time was rushing by. She'd reached the roaring 40s, and the future began to look pretty bleak and pretty grim. She'd conceived a few times and always got rid of it, but this one time she decided to go ahead with it. To sort of fill a gap in her life.
This is where the violin started, eh?
Only after she'd had the baby, she began to regret it. It was a real little tiger, this one. Screaming morning, noon and night. No sleep, no social life. Nothing but crying, gripes, dirty nappies.
What do you expect life with a kid to be like?
Well, she's pretty stupid, I suppose. Anyway, she couldn't handle it. So she decided to give it away.
Oh, great.
To someone she thought would look after it. And it didn't work out that way. The kid had a pretty rough time of it.
Why are you telling me all this garbage?
Because I... Oh, just an old woman rabbiting on. Anyway, but later on, she came to realise what she'd done. And wanted to trace the kid. Years later, she tracked her down and found a young, healthy woman who loved life and in spite of all the setbacks she had.
What did the kid do, spit in her face?
No. Reckon she had one thing to thank her mother for.
Such as?
Not having an abortion like all
yeah,
the
well,
other
times. Yeah, well, it took you a while to get round to it, didn't
Let's
it?
Let's see,
bloody waste of breath. Look, all I will be doing is getting rid of a six-week-old nothing I didn't want anyway. That stupid bitch had hers and got rid of it. If I was a kid, I'd bloody well murder her.
You don't understand.
Just leave me alone, you stupid old cow.
When are you coming through with the coke?
Oh, there's been a slight hitch. Give me a bit of time, we'll be flying.
No worries.
Keep it down around Nance and Jess, okay?
Oh, will you think I'm crazy? Geez, it's mostly junk.
It's not just the battery.
Oh, who'd be parting with an expensive gizmo like this if it was just the battery?
Might be a broken circuit. Hmm? Hey, yeah, see that loose wire?
Which one?
I could get that going with a bit of solder from the workshop.
Oh, smart little bugger, aren't you? Hey, when you leave here, you ought to start your own business. Chookies Fixin' Service. Sounds great, eh?
Yeah.
Oh, look. I used to have one like this when I was little. Call her Matilda. Oh, just didn't have a cracked head, but. Hey, is that a water pistol over there?
Let me guess, you were going to take it back to your dorm to fix it.
Yeah, that's right. Nothing wrong with that, is there?
Of course not. Some of us ride Harleys, others like playing with dolls. It's okay, keep it. Only kidding. We've all got big hearts, right, girls?
Yeah. Thanks.
Oh, she's right. I am a bloody stupid, selfish bitch.
In the past, maybe, but it's now that matters, and you're doing what's right.
I just couldn't bring myself to tell her after she said that.
But when she knows the whole story, she'll forgive you. I know she will.
Oh, Nance, I hope you're right.
Well, you have to do it sometime, Jess.
Sorry to do this, Governor, but I have to leave at once. Manage without me for a bit?
I suppose. When will you be back?
Not sure. I'll bring you.
Anything I can help with?
Personal problem.
Take as long as you need.
Thanks.
Seems a bit rattled. Wonder what's wrong. Must be serious for him to walk out in the middle of a shift.
Irresponsible, more like it. The man's coming apart at the seams. Happens to people, you know, when they get demoted. With that oversized ego, he probably can't handle it.
You wish to make an official complaint about it, Joan?
It's only an opinion.
Then keep it to yourself. Oh, by the way, have you spoken to Joyce yet?
About what?
About withdrawing that complaint you made about her.
I haven't seen her.
But you will, won't you? I mean, I know she'd like you to put her mind at rest.
She's climbed down a bit, hasn't she?
Mm, she has, rather.
Hey, Steve.
Oh, g'day, Lexi.
I've got a proposition for you. How'd you like to make $2,000?
Who wouldn't?
No, fair dinkum. I mean, I've got it saved up. Be the easiest day you ever made.
You're going to give me $2,000? What for?
Well, I'm 6 weeks gone. All you've got to do is get rid of it for me.
What?
Well, you're a doctor, aren't you? It should be a breeze. I mean, all I've got to do is tee us up a bit of privacy.
Hey, hold on. What makes you think I'd do something like that?
Oh, come on, mate. You've got to help me, please. It's just all a big mistake.
Oh, you're talking about an illegal operation.
Okay, but what the bloody hell are you doing here?
Get inside. Hop it, Steve. And forget whatever it was she told you.
I already have.
I said, get in there.
Would you stop hanging around like a bloody bad smell all the time?
Shut up and listen to me.
Oh, I don't need no more bloody lectures.
I'm not going to let you. I'm going to tell you something. I'm going to tell you something about your mother that you don't know.
What would you bloody know about my mother?
I know everything about her. She's that woman I've been telling you about.
Oh, what a lot of crap. My mother didn't dump me till I was 14. I've already told you that.
Yeah. I know all about Lady Giddings, too, and none of it good. But she wasn't your real mother. She was only the one you were farmed out to.
Oh, you're off your rocker. Why are you making up all this bull?
It's not bull. It's the God's honest truth. And you know how I know? Because it's me I'm talking about. Me! Look at me. I'm your real mother.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again, but that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down, but the sun and rain are prisoners too. Right.